So you're underwater in a state of no gravity, but now you're surrounded by some of Mother Nature's most incredible marine life to be found anywhere on the planet. You can just kind of spin around slowly and look at a zoo of animal and plant life that you just can't see anywhere else. It really is the most diverse environment on the planet.
We have got the best beaches in the whole world. We can do anything we want to here. We can go boating, we can go fishing, we can go snorkeling. Oh my goodness, I love this place.
Regardless of who you are or where you come from, few people can dispute the beauty of the North Queensland coast. Yet these pristine waters are at the centre of the biggest environmental dispute in Australia.
The federal government has given the go-ahead for the dredging.
The Great Barrier Reef is dying.
It's not just about jobs, it's about families.
Protesters are filthy at the federal government. The controversy is over the decision to dump 3 million cubic metres of dredge spoil into the Great Barrier Reef Marine Park. It's part of the expansion at the Abbott Point coal terminal that could see it become the biggest in the world.
We have to take chances, but they've got to be calculated. And I think this is what we're looking at. I think it's a calculated risk.
Just 25 kilometres south of Abbott Point is the coastal town of Bowen, home to around 10,000 people.
Another shock police here, they left town.
Tracy Henry's lived here for almost a decade and runs a pool business.
The last 2 years have been absolutely horrendous. People are walking away from their homes. I'm getting phone calls from friends knowing their business is going down. There's not a damn bloody thing I can do about it. And it breaks my heart. Hi, girls.
Hi, Tracy.
How are you?
Bowen's close-knit community relies heavily on mining, fishing and agriculture. But in recent years, locals say there's been a downturn and morale is low. Enter the Abbott Point expansion, a project set to create around 15,000 permanent jobs and pump $30 billion into Queensland's economy. That's music to the ears of many Bowen locals.
There's so many unemployed people in town that they could probably train and use.
We're hoping more people will come, more industries.
Confidence has gone right up.
Well, I think the Abbott Point decision's taken a long, long time to come. It's held people back.
I think it's about compromise. Don't think you have to dump it in the sea.
I'm not surprised that many of the people in Bowen, not all of them, mind you, are very much in favour of the development at Abbott Point. Bowen will probably benefit economically from the expanded coal port terminal, but it's going to come at a cost to the Great Barrier Reef.
Tony Fonts has been a dive instructor on the reef for over 30 years.
The Great Barrier Reef, World Heritage Area, it's an icon. People coming from around the world come to Australia for many reasons, but one of the top reasons is to see the Great Barrier Reef. And why? Because it's the most beautiful coral reef on the planet. Well, I guess the worst case scenario for us is that the dredge spoils travel much further than the current science says they should.
For Tony, dumping dredge spoil around the reef is simply too risky. Authorities say the dumping will have a minimal impact. Tony says there's no guarantee.
It's a well-known fact that one of the pressures that is recognised that's causing some the degradation of the reef today is water quality. And when you dump another 3 million cubic metres of dredge spoil on the reef, how can that help the water quality?
According to the Marine Park Authority, the dredge spoils are a mixture of sand and mud. They'll be dumped 40 kilometres from the nearest coral and be contained within a 4 square kilometre disposal area that has no coral or seagrass beds. There are also 47 environmental conditions that the authority says are the strictest in Australia's history.
They look really good on paper, but I think in reality, it's going to be very difficult to actually put these into place. Very expensive, and at the end of the day, the ability to monitor or force compliance is going to be extremely difficult as well.
The Marine Park Authority has made it clear that its preference was to dump the spoils on land, but that was found to be too costly. This is the first of several proposed port expansions along the North Queensland coast.
The campaign makes it look like the dredge spoils have absolutely no effect on the reef, and that is just not at all true. It has a tremendous effect on the water quality. It degrades the reef, and for anybody to say anything different is an outright lie. There have been a number of surveys done that show that the majority of Australians do not want dredge spoils dumped in the Great Barrier Reef. So I think the government's made a big mistake.
Tracy's support of the plan is about striking a delicate balance between the economic interests of locals and the environmental interests of the country.
I'm not prepared to put the reef on the line. No way in the world. It's the most important thing. It's beautiful. I have a triage facility here in Bowen for sick and injured turtles. Do you think that I would want my turtles injured, my sea life injured? No way in the world. Let's get employment. Let's make us profitable. That's the most important thing. This decision is the best thing for Bowen and for North Queensland. That's why I'm hoping they're not going to stuff up.